P6 and P7.
I wish things had gone differently in ordinary for us. Wishing won't change things. Finding the projector will.
There's so much coming together in this one case. A new object of power, something we have not seen before. I mean, coming from me, that's saying something. And the boy, Dylan Faden, prime candidate 6. And the sister as well. Well, once we catch up with her, but the boy, so much potential. We're talking Northmore level readings here. And I don't want to invoke his name, but it's completely different circumstances here. It's remarkable. There was an incident. Yes. We lost a valuable member of our team, yes. Excessive force. Dylan has so much. But he's just a kid. I'll take the blame. He needs some slack. I mean, boys will be boys. He's exceptional and under a lot of stress. Roberts got killed. It's an unfortunate accident, that's all. Marshall needs to realize this. We will make this work. We'll make this work.
Is this what Dylan wanted me to see? It doesn't matter. We need to find that projector. All the times I felt paranoid, I was right. The Bureau could have given me the answers, but they just stood by and watched me. I studied what happened in Ordinary here. That's the place to start looking. I were both prime candidates. Experiments. We're going back home. Of course we are. It started there, and it's... Gotta be a way to rotate these tracks. Maybe there's a control panel nearby. won't rotate. Something's blocking it.
You're listening to America Overnight, celebrating 29 years shining a light in the shadows.
There is a curious correlation with the yet unknowable forces intruding upon our world, in the form of altered world events. These forces gravitate toward archetypal objects, a gun, a television, a supposedly haunted house. So clearly humanity affects this process. Our collective unconscious is a map of sorts. We hold the key, but we don't know how to use it. We create these archetypes through everyday life, popular culture, urban legends, but we are observing and influencing a complicated system in action. We can change the likelihood of something being a receptacle for these forces just by thinking about it. But we haven't found a method to control the outcome. And yet, there's something unique in us, in our dreams, in the conceptual reality with power, with our minds. What's the cause and what's the effect? Are we the starting point or just a necessary evil in this? A byproduct, a reflection, a projection? We'll struggle to find the answers to these hard questions, or die trying.
I'm afraid we're gonna have to cut you off.
Annual evaluation of Dylan Faden, formerly P6, performed by Dr. Carla Vaughn. The questions asked here correspond to the fifth iteration of the Gunner's psychological assessment. Are you ready, Dylan? Let's begin then. In a single word, describe the world around you.
Where's Casper?
Dr. Darling is out of the building today.
He's never out. He didn't want to come, did he? Visits, not since Roberts. Tell Darling it wasn't my fault. I couldn't control it yet. What?
Let's see what they have on ordinary. It's all here. Our home, our school, the woods, the dump.
Thank you.
slide projector in the dump outside town. Did they recreate that too? Is that where they keep it?
You mentioned a poem last time we talked. By Thomas Zane?
Yes.
Landfill here in the middle of New York, and nobody saw a thing. Pretty unbelievable.
Effective immediately. I'm setting up a new department. Dimensional research in the research sector. Transferring the slide projector there. That's where my focus will be now. The ordinary site remains as is. We'll be back to... I don't know when.
Darling took the projector to the research sector. He dedicated a whole area to it, so he knew it was important. Dimensional research. That's where we go next.
Thank you.
endangering us by bringing a hissing. If Trench was still around, he'd have stopped us.
You die, but the mystery distorts you. Happiness comes, white burns to yellow.
Maybe I'm just here to punish myself.
Any new dreams you'd like to share, Dylan?
I'm glad you asked, sister. This dream, like all dreams now, felt very real. Like reality. And reality now feels like a dream. Maybe it's all a dream. Maybe it's all real.
Dream where my brother endlessly tells me about his dreams.
I was in a dark place, and there was a dark man there. His name was Mr. Door, and he told me that there are many worlds, side by side, on top of each other, some inside of others. In one world, there was a writer who wrote a story about a cop. In another world, the cop was real. Dor said he himself was in all of them at the same time, endlessly shifting between them. I asked him how I could reach these worlds. I wanted to bring the hiss there. But he didn't want to help me. He didn't like the idea. What did he know?
I'm not wild about the idea myself.
Through time, the thunderstorm distorts you. Happiness comes, white burns, but yellow and red and black.